So I think there's one person watching right now. One person. And thank you. That's all I have to say. This is Gray's Guitar. This is the first live, or maybe technically the second, I think, that I've been doing. And any comments, questions, appreciative, because that's how the live, moves forward. I think I want a light. I think I want a better light. We're going to be doing a setup on this guitar throughout the live video as well. But I think I want to get a light, so I'm going to do that. Will I edit this out after the fact? 50-50. 50-50. Let's go get a light. Gonna put the guitar, the SG down for a minute. Goes. And yeah, I'm always pulling up my pants. What else is new? You see that in all my reviews too. Let's see what this looks like. Not terrible. I think we need to just adjust it a little bit. Maybe not directly on my face. And maybe a little more. Wonder. We'll leave it. It's a good angle, I think. Yeah, not bad. I feel like I got a little bit of a shadow right here. But yet again, first live. So so we're gonna figure this out as we go along. I did do a short today, and I mentioned that I was going live. So I may make this a regular thing. It depends on do I get people that are actually joining the live. I'm going to try to stay alive for about an hour, at least. And what we're going to do on to this live today is I figured I would do a setup on this Gibson SG. It's technically an SGJ. The previous owner got rid of the J on the headstock. So it just says SG, but it's a 2014. I think they call it like a worn cherry or something. Satin finish, it's used, but pretty cool overall. I traded it for the LTD EC Black Metal. I don't know if you want me to do like a trade update. I do periodically trade instruments. I got this recently, and I also got an Epiphone Les Paul Prophecy, which I'm not as happy with because I'm pretty sure it needs fretwork. But this one I don't think needs fretwork. What we're going to start with, just to show you, is this is a fret rocker tool. So essentially this is going to tell you if the frets are high or low, and it's really easy. You just go on here and actually, oh great, already a little bit of movement, already off to a bad start. So I think my second fret is either low or high. I'm not an expert. I've never actually filed frets, and I really don't want to. All right, we're doing good so far. I'm actually just curious. Yeah, there's definitely a high fret up there. Not an issue. Nothing. Maybe a little bit right there. A little bit. Yeah, a little bit right there. And then you just turn it as you go down the length of the guitar neck. Oh, actually, I do not like that shadow. A little bit. And it's interesting that this actually has, well, there's a couple of frets here that definitely have a little bit of wiggle. That one's kind of bad. That's the 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, the 17th fret. think is kind of bad. Yeah, there's definitely some spots on here that have a little bit of high frets. The thing is, though, is does it actually affect anything? In this case, I don't really think so, because I have a bunch of picks, you know, and you just do the 1-2-3-4 exercise, which is just... And you can do it with one finger too, if that makes you feel better. It doesn't make a difference. And I'm not really hearing any buzzing there. One thing I didn't grab is a tuner, which is behind me, but at the moment, I don't need that. So the first thing you want to do is check the relief. So you don't have to have a capo. I'll show you the way without the capo first. It's a little bit harder. So essentially what you do is first finger at the first fret. You want your thumb, some or pinky, either or, preferably your thumb, wherever the neck first meets the body. You take your pinky, get it up as high as it can go, and just tap a little bit. Make sure you're not touching the string with your like your index finger or something. And it shouldn't be flat on the fret. If it's flat on the fret, that means you need to adjust the truss rod. There's not enough relief. But it also shouldn't be miles off the fretboard either. If it's really, really high off of the fretboard, then also you need some adjustment. Ideally, you want around 12 thousandths of an inch. What is that in millimeters? I wouldn't be able to tell you off the top of my head. The best way I do it is because I don't have a feeler gauge. That is another tool you can use. This is a 10 gauge E string. And what I do is I capo the first fret so I have a hand free. Then I stick my finger down here. And this particular guitar, it's around the 18th fret because it does have 24 frets. And then between the 7th fret and the 9th fret, that's where you're going to have the most relief area. You just stick it in there and see how much you can get. Now this is getting caught up just a hair on that 9th fret, which is perfectly fine. Because remember, I said 12 thousandths of an inch is good. So that means this string should just barely be able to go through the string and the fret. I'm doing it on the low E string here. And in reality, I don't think this even needs a neck adjustment right now. The next thing you can do is if you have something like this, this is a not straight edge, is you can also check the relief. And this has two scales on it, a 24¾ and a 25½ inch scale length. And what you do is you just put it on the guitar neck, line it up with the frets, depending on the scale length of the guitars, and you just look. So I don't know if you'll catch this on camera, but there should be a very small gap here in the middle. If it's super, you know, super huge, you're going to want to adjust the neck. And then if there's a gap on either end, you know, and by your high frets or by your upper frets right here, at that point, you also then need to adjust your truss rod. Because the first thing you really want to do with making any guitar adjustments is adjust the truss rod. Once the truss rod is adjusted, at that point, you are free to mess with the string height. And then I would say the last thing you're going to mess with is probably intonation, which you do need a tuner for. Yet again, that is behind me. So the next thing I'm going to do is I have this D'Addario string action gauge. It's 1 inch equals 25.4 millimeters. It even tells you right there. On the back of it, it gives you a bunch of conversions, which is really cool. It tells you like what your ideal string height should be, things along those lines. And it tells you on a bass, an acoustic guitar, and electric guitar. So on the low E string, for a low action, or for a standard action, you would be putting it at about 1.98 millimeters. So roughly 2 millimeters, give or take. In inches, that's 78 thousandths of an inch. And then on the high string, your high E, you're looking for about 1.6 millimeters or 63 thousandths of an inch. For an acoustic, you want it higher. You bought 2.3 millimeters on the high E, and then 1.8 millimeters on the, 2.3 millimeters on the low E, 1.8 millimeters on the high E. Now, a bass guitar, which I have seen several set up very badly. I've actually set up a couple of basses recently. They're setting them up like a guitar. Bass strings have to be higher off of the fretboard. And the reason bass strings have to be higher off of the fretboard is because there's more vibrations and more buzz. So on this, it even tells you that your low E on a bass should be about 2.7 millimeters off of the fretboard. This is based all at the 12th fret. So you're measuring the action based on the 12th fret of the guitar. Then the would be your D string on a bass, they're saying about 2.38. So even your lowest string on a bass should be higher than your lowest string on the guitar. So we take your string action gauge. I like using millimeters. Some people like using inches. It's a preference. And we just put it on here and see where we're at. Now, right now, it is currently sitting at 2.25 because I did actually adjust it a little bit before this. And let's take a look at the high E. High E sitting at about 1.75. So the reality of it is that's where I like it. I like my action around 2.25 for the low E and then about 1.75 for the high E. And you can go a little bit lower, a little bit higher. If you get it under 1.5 millimeters, let me see if I can figure out what that equivalent is. Let's see, millimeters. So 1/16th of an inch. At that point, it is going to be very buzzy, most likely. So I really wouldn't go below that. I mean, if your guitar allows it, by all means. It all depends on the individual person, the individual player, how hard they're hitting the strings. Me, I hit a little bit harder, so I have to have higher action. And as long as there's no buzzing, you're perfectly fine. Now, the Prophecy that I have, unfortunately, I think has worse fret issues than this particular guitar, which is why I'm probably going to be getting rid of it. So I have never done fret work in my life, and I'm not about to start on a $900 guitar. So minimum, a fret job is going to cost you $250. Which I don't want to spend that on that guitar. I'll be honest with you. I can trade it for something else. I can sell it for, you know, $700 pretty easily right now in the market. So if I don't keep it, not the end of the world. I have another guitar that has Fishman pickups in it. Yes, they're not technically the same because Epiphone has their own specific set of Fishman Fluences. But I have the Fishman Fluence Modern. Even though that guitar, I'm looking for a better neck on. So the Warmoth, which I have showed you a long time ago, it's been a while since I put the Warmoth on the channel. That particular guitar, the neck is a super wide, and it's thick. It's like, whoop, and I hate it. I just really, really hate it. Not a fan, and I want to replace the neck. So that's that. Eventually, I'm going to find a neck. It's been hard. I've been looking for Gibson conversion scale because I like the Gibson scale length better. I prefer it over the 25.5. It also depends on what music I'm playing. So, you know, typically what I'm playing, your dad rock, if you will. I'm not playing the crazy heavy metal stuff and drop tuning. I'm usually either in drop D or standard tuning. So 24 3/4 is perfectly fine for me. I'm looking for a darker wood. It doesn't have to be maple or roasted maple or whatever. The material I think is Galco Elvis. I'm probably butchering the name out of that. It's got a Pau Ferro fretboard. I don't really care. It just has to be darker to match the guitar. Non-reverse headstock preferred, not super wide. I'm either looking at the standard thin profile they offer or the 59. And I've been trying to find a used one because new, it's like $300, and I didn't pay that for the entire guitar. Got a really good deal on that guitar, and I know I didn't pay more than $300 for it, so I'm not about to spend $300 on a neck. So I'm trying to find a used one, decent price, you know, something I don't have to touch the frets, because I don't have the tools currently to do any type of fret leveling work. And I would do it so little, I can't justify spending hundreds of dollars on StuMac stuff, so I'd probably end up getting the cheap Amazon stuff and possibly be aggravated, being that it may not work as well. But I've never bought the sets. I don't know. If I do ever try it, I need to try it on a cheapo guitar first. The problem is the Squire back there, the cheapest guitar I own, that doesn't have any issues. There's no fret problems. So I'm not going to dress the frets on something that I don't have issues with. I need to buy another guitar or cheapy guitar or something to try it on, because I would prefer not to practice on a $900 guitar. As I said, you know, I'm not definitely not doing it on my Gibsons. My Gibsons really don't have any issues, but I feel like at the Gibson level, if it's anything above $500 and you don't know what you're doing, it's your first time, bring it to a professional, because you don't want to scratch up your fretboard. You don't want to mess up your frets where you get to refret the entire guitar, because that's another tool you have to buy, and it is just a mess, you know. You really need someone that has the skill and knows what they're doing to maybe teach you how to do it. You know, I mean, you can definitely do it yourself. It's basically, you have a crowning tool, a fret file tool, some sort of file set for the edges, if the edges are sharp, and then a leveling beam. You know, you got to have some sort of leveling beam to file the frets down. You need a fret rocker, which is this. I don't know if I trust this one, though, because it is very cheap, and I'm not getting any buzzing, but at the same time, like, it looks like a straight edge to me. That's something you have to be wary of, too. Make sure you buy a good quality fret rocker, because if you do not buy a good quality fret rocker, then you're going to think all these frets are uneven and not level, well, in reality, is they're fine. As I said, this one, it's rocking at a few points, but I don't know if that's because the neck isn't perfectly straight. You also do not want to use this when the neck isn't perfectly straight, because right now this has a very slight relief that may be causing the frets to, you know, wiggle a slight amount because the neck is slightly bent forward. Not a lot, but without the neck being perfectly straight, which is why you have the neck gauge right here, you don't always know if that fret is actually an issue or not, because that's how fret rockers work. You know, it has to be perfectly straight. If the neck is not perfectly straight, then you could be messing with a fret that actually doesn't have any issues whatsoever. So that is the first thing you do when you're using the fret rocker. Before you touch anything, you make sure the neck is perfectly straight on the guitar, and then you go in there with the fret rocker. And then after that, you know, you start sanding away with the leveling beam. And you're not really going to hurt anything. In a worst case scenario, as I said, you have to rip all the frets out of the guitar. And refrets, I think, are like $300 plus, depending on the material. You know, like a guitar like this, yeah, sure, this is a $1,000 guitar. So I would justify it at some point in time, refretting it. But right now, it doesn't need anything. I mean, I think it plays halfway decent. I'll go through. I had a pick. I don't know what I did with it. I'm on a standing desk. Good enough. But I think this is in tune. Also holding it at a very weird angle right now, too. Honestly, I might need to adjust the truss rod just a tiny, tiny bit. I might have to straighten the truss rod just a smidgen. So let's go ahead and do that. Since we're on the live, you know, I've only been doing this for like 15 minutes or so. Actually, I don't even know how long I've been doing this. But yeah, you need truss rod wrenches too. Those always help. I'm actually curious how long I've been doing this. Let's see, does it say from the beginning? Oh, I've been doing this for about 20 minutes. All right, that's fine. That's perfectly fine. As I said, we're gonna probably do this for about an hour or so. But we'll adjust the truss rod live here on camera. Oh, don't want to lose my screw. Something that's really nice to have, this is a small magnetic dish. So if you have, you know, this was like some Harbor Freight thing, came in a kit for like 10 bucks. Very good for small screws and not losing them. All right, we're just gonna move the truss rod cover to the side there. And I really should only need to loosen this, I don't know, like a quarter of a turn maybe. Righty tighty, lefty loosey, and I got plenty of adjustment room on there. I'm actually keeping the truss rod cover on because lazy, but that's what the truss rod looks like, and all I did is I went counterclockwise about a quarter of a turn. So we're going to let that flop. We're just going to do this. Make sure the neck is nice and straight. And then we're going to check my relief again. Like I showed you before, keep it with the first fret. Get your feeler gauge, or in my case, my string, and then 7 to 9. And now that's actually catching on every single one. So that may be exactly where we need it. We'll go ahead and play a little bit. Try that again. Maybe I should just take this off completely. We'll try it. Why not? And there's your truss rod cover where someone took the J off for whatever reason. They just didn't like it on there. I have no idea why. You can actually see a line. You can see a line with it. I don't know if you can see it up close, but it used to say SGJ on the truss rod cover. I guess the owner didn't like that, so is what it is. I just like having SGs because it's my initials. So let's see here. Just want to make sure you didn't create buzz somewhere else, you know? And usually I do the first fret, I do around the 12th fret. That's me, not the actual guitar. I'm out of practice, too. Actually curious if the nut is cut right over here too. That can also cause issues. Is the nut too shallow? So to test the nut, I hold down one finger at the third fret and then just in there. Really should be the tiniest bit of room between the string and the first fret, and I'm talking like minuscule. But you should be able to feel it. And that E string. It's really hard to tell. Let's use my 1/10 of an inch and see if I can get this under the first fret. Yeah, I just lost the string. Oop. But I think we're good. I mean, we can always raise the action a smidgen if we have to. We really shouldn't have to. It's at about 1.75. Then, yeah, our low E is about 1.25, but... My cat has decided to grace you with his presence. Maybe I'm going crazy. A good thing to do is take another guitar and just play the same frets and see if it sounds the same. Hi, cat. Here's the prophecy. This ain't in tune either. But back to the Gibson. Yeah, I think it's just me. Sometimes you think you're hearing something and you're not. You're going crazy. But yeah, I think we're pretty much set up. Tailpiece wise down here, actually I see where I might have to make an adjustment. Piece of paper. There we go. Piece of paper. So what you want to do with the bridge here on your Tune-O-Matics is you just want to make sure a piece of paper can fit through there. And I mean kind of. I may erase that a tiny bit. Let's do that. So to do that, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And basically you just want to make sure your strings are floppy. I actually used the string gauge because that is really all you need. And we are just going to raise that a hair. I think I actually need more tension relief, so we are going to do the other strings too. He found my guitar pick to play with. There we are. And now we got a tuner back up. A time to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. And the reason I'm counting is because you can roughly get it back to where it was if you count the number of times you turn the knobs. 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I told you I had a pick. I lost it. Cat found it. And then we take our piece of paper again here. Yeah, it's much better. Because that could be causing an issue as well. We're not in tune at all. I gotta grab my tuner. Now this thing is very finicky when not plugged in. We'll see if it wants to cooperate. If not, I'm gonna have to get a cable. Not a big deal. You gotta be careful, gotta make sure you know which way you're going. Because you can break strings, and I've done it. I broke a D string the other day, which is kind of impressive. I have never broken one of those before. Actually, that was when I was tuning the prophecy. I'm going to shut up here for a second so I can tune. I actually went a little past the note. Went too high. Alright, should be in tune. Not completely in tune, but close enough. And I'm just doing the 12th fret and up, because typically past the 12th fret, as you don't really have too many issues. I mean, I can do that. And I like to use my pointer finger and middle finger for a lot of it, because those are, I would argue, are my two strongest fingers. My pinky's always the weakest. So, listening. You also want to make sure you're hitting it at the correct angle. I don't have a strap, so it's a little hard, but... And you can do bends wherever, too. Yeah, I think we're in business with this particular... I know I'm having issues with the prophecy, but this one's set up fairly nicely. I did mess with it the other day, just a hair. But this has nines on it. As I said, we're low E's, about 2.25. High E, 1.75 roughly. Maybe a smidgen higher. But when you're heavy-handed like I am, you got to do what you got to do. I appreciate the one person that stayed with me the entire time.